Hi there. In this video we are going to be assembling this Malm cabinet with lots of drawers inside of it. We'll be opening the first package, number one, but in total there are three packages for this to get the final product. So let's get to it. Opened up the boxes. This is the top part, but I've turned it upside down because we need to work on these holes installing stuff. These are the sides, this and this. And this is the middle part right here, which is really, really, really thick, which is cool. And it basically doesn't have a bottom, so it has just other smaller stuff that are right there. This is the back of it, folded into a few parts. But they are glued together, so when you unfold them, it's all good. And yeah, lots of stuff there. A few rails in there. These two things already have these rails onto them, so we need to install six rails onto this. And in another package, probably we'll have all the drawers. So this is just the base cabinet. So let's get to using this manual to install it. Install those things. Make sure you take a good look at them, because this is right hand side version. They have an R on them. Left hand side version will go on the other side of this thing. Then installed four of these standoffs, like you see there. And now I'm installing these things right in here, which basically will be the bottom of this thing that we can see from the outside. So let's get to it. To install these things, we use this type of tiny screws so they get out of the way of in this rail. And for this, we have these huge ones. Okay, these things are attached. Now, these weird plastics, probably onto this, we will have a bit of sliding from the drawer itself, I'm guessing. Not really sure, but anyway, we need to put them in here, IKEA says so. Come on, get in there. Okay, and at this point, in theory, at least from what I can gather, I think this is installing right in there, something like this. Yep, so it seems. Take two. These plastic things are on the bottom, so my father just noticed they probably are the little feet, and we have two holes here and two holes here, so probably even here we will install some little feet later. At this point we are installing the wooden dowels into three of these types, really thin ones, white on two sides, wood on two others. So we need to have three of these here, and this one in here. And yes, wooden dowels, you just put them in the smaller hole and smack them with a hammer. And then in the bigger hole, this thing actually enters. And from the back of it, we will tighten it with this sort of thing. Although I took a wrong one, I think. Probably with this sort of thing, actually. It will be like this, and then you rotate it like this. So initially the arrow is pointing towards this plate, and at the end it needs to be pointing upwards to show that it's pulling stuff together. So let me do that now. Just want to show you how to tighten one of these things. You push it right in there, and now it's tight. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. But yes, it is still able to move. And you will line it up with this side. Mm-hmm. Installed the standoffs, actually, four of them in the corresponding holes to align with this and with these three things. We already have that in there. which will align with this, and we tighten two screws in there. And for the standoffs, of course, we are using those things. Basically, at this point, we turn this thing around and did a piece on this part, exactly as we did on the other part. And now we'll be straining this one, but I just wanted to show you this little thing. That's not nice, is it? I will glue it in there, but it's just a foil glued to the wood, and it's not really, come on, line. It's not really staying in place that well, so that I do not like at all. If you are unable to get last one of these in place, something does not line up, undo the two screws from this thing, let it sit on in here, and tighten the screws on this, and then tighten the ones in here. Hopefully, then it will work. We did it a bit backwards because we installed onto this side all of these things, but IKEA was telling us to install them on this and then come with the whole AC on and match it with this. Same result. Now we are installing the standoffs onto the six holes from the top part. Done that. Now we are at number 24, where it tells us to prepare these things. Because IKEA, it seems, wants everything tied to a wall, probably for legal reasons, and I can understand that. So we have this one, plus one of this, and this will be adjustable depending on how far you want it from the wall. And we will do the same at the other end with the second one. And this, presumably two of them, for this, which we will put into the wall. Not sure if we are actually installing this onto the wall, but we can do it. And that's just an error, a spare. Because in theory, you should only have two of these. Actually, no, probably they show you more somewhere. Not sure where. Anyway, never mind. Installed those things, also installed small wooden dowels, bigger ones in the middle, only two of them we had, again two small ones at the end, and we are ready to put this on top of this, and then for each and every one of these things we have stuff in here, and I think we have a spare, and these two in the middle will be going through this thing, which is obviously thicker, so it needs to reach the middle, the longer ones. All the little feet are smacked into the appropriate position. Put these things in place. It seems there are two. I thought it's one folded in four. No, they are two folded in two. And for each and one, every one of them, we have these little nails, which we will go all around with them, and yeah, that's about it. Hammer time. Before getting the nails in, camera focus onto something, anything, make sure you measure the diagonals, both of them, because after you get the nails in, this thing is much sturdier, so if it's not level, the top of it, it's crooked, you cannot do anything about it once the nails are in. Making the drawers for this thing, opened up the package, three of the drawers in this package and three in a similar one. These are the fronts, quite thick as you can see, but it's only aesthetic, helps nothing. Sides, there are three backs and one side, and hinges there, and screws and whatnot in the other one. So yeah, and the bottom for these things, so they are gray. All the inside of it is gray, outside white. Nice. Let's do this. If you don't find a manual in the first box, it means you don't know how to count like me, and you actually took box number 3 instead of box number 2. So box number 2 getting closed, using this to assemble box number 3. What can you do? Doing all three from the package number 3 in parallel. Installed these stands, put the wooden dowels in place, and now we are putting the sides in. They are rounded on the top, and the top is this with a slant in it. Round this, this needs to be in on both sides. And yeah, again, they are telling us that a child could climb onto the drawers and it could topple onto him or her. So yeah, in the end, I think I will actually put some screws in the wall on both sides, because always better safe than sorry. So thank you, IKEA, for insisting. Now I'm going to put this on all of the others and then follow the next steps. Tighten again some of these things in place like we did before, then just simply put this thing, the back of it or the bottom actually, put it in that slot right there, and it will basically not attach to anything for the moment. And you come with the end of the drawer and you slide it into here and into here, and in theory then with that cut it will hold this for a while in place until we put other braces under it. It's gonna be quite tricky to get this, the bottom, into that channel, and this, the end, into the channel from this. We need it to push on them, make sure that it doesn't catch the edge and peel off this plastic, because these are plastics once again. It's tricky, and then you slam it with your hand and it's there. And now we need to put these things in here, the plastics, to hold everything in place. After these are hammered in place, we install these little caps, camera focus, maybe, into these little holes. I think they are actually kind of replacing the silicone pads. When you close this thing, it will bump into this, so it doesn't make a wood-on-wood noise. Next, we install the rails. Make sure you get this at the bottom of the drawer and, as you can see, lower. But I don't think you can install them any other way. These are the screws that we use. And yeah, put this so they are one for left and obviously one for right. We install them on each and every one of these drawers. Be careful to not damage that edge. They recommend you to put it on something in here, so that edge is in air, but it's on cardboard, so shouldn't be damaged, I hope. Next, we need to install this. Tighten the screw, but not fully, so there is a small edge behind it, because this will come from the side, go in there and rotate. Camera focus, let's try that again. Go in there and rotate, and it's locked in place. And now you go with this edge below and it's doing its job, and you come with another screw of the same type in here, which you actually tighten fully. That one, it will never be fully tightened, because this thing is just pushing on it like this, so it doesn't matter if it's fully tightened or not. And anyway, look at this, it's quite a thin material, so it's not super strong, but it will not bend, and this is hold also on this. It's good for drawers. This I consider are decent. Okay, let's put this thing in. You go slowly, it goes on top of that other wheel and it's in. And now just do 5 more. And again, yes, that will be fixed with some glue. Drill to the holes, put that plastic thing that I have no idea how it's called in. And next, this thing is going in there. And after this is tightened, I will also tighten the top one and do the same on the other side, and we are done. Put some wood glue under the corner that was opening up, something like this. And a bit of masking tape to hold it tucked in both corners. From this corner I could peel the whole thing off if I wanted to, so that kind of sucks. IKEA, if you're watching this, that's not good. Use more glue to attach this to the wood. Anyway, I will let it dry and then we should be done. And it's glued. Finally. Yeah, let's put this drawer back. You kind of need to make sure again that the wheels from one pass the wheels from the stationary part and go into this channel, and that on the both sides, and you are kind of done. And I really like the fact that this goes right next to the end. There are many kind of cabinets like this with small drawers. I don't see the purpose of those ones. This, you utilize the whole space. Great. A word of advice for whoever stayed this long through the video. If you cannot get the distances between these drawers perfectly, start swapping drawers. I just needed to swap these two between them. I had too much of a gap here and too little here. I swapped these two and now it's perfect. So yeah, that's that. Hope this helps somebody out there. And we are finished. So hope this video helps you. This thing, in my opinion, is really, really nice because it has a lot of internal space and it doesn't have bells and whistles, so it doesn't clutter the room. Yeah, good choice if you want to buy this, in my opinion. And again, hope this video helps you assemble it, see what's made of before purchasing maybe. And as always, if you like what you see, subscribe, check out my other videos, and as always, see you in the next one. If you want to see that video, for example, with lots of fingerprints of the glass because it's not wiped yet, just finished installing it, it will be linked in the description below. So yeah, that's about it. Bye.